Our scripture is from John 15, and Jeannie has agreed to read for us.
As the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than that, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you to do.
Did I read the right place?
That's right. The Bible, as you know, talks a lot about love. And in this section from John 15, there's several things that really jump out at us. Jesus said, if you love me, keep my commandments. Now, is that the Ten Commandments? Is it canon law? What commandments is Jesus talking about? And you may remember that Jesus was asked, what is the greatest commandment? And the reply, the answer was, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. And the second one is like it. It's love your neighbor as yourself. So, I'm going to suggest that that's the commandments Jesus is talking about. Not the commandments about what day we should worship, or what we should wear, or anything like that, but rather love God with everything and love your neighbor in the same way you want to be loved. But then that challenges us with a question. What is love? Love is not a feeling. Now, if you're talking about romantic love, it is, but not the love that God talks about. It's not a feeling. It is a choice. In the Bible, love means I choose to behave properly, respectfully, and compassionately toward you. Even if you don't do that to me. In the Bible, love is simply a choice to behave in a way that mirrors what Jesus did and what God calls us to and what the Spirit will help us to be. If you love me, keep my commandments. Another thing in this passage of scripture that Jeannie read was, I give you a new commandment. Love one another. See, if we choose to respect each other, then we are loving. Some days that's a little harder than others. I don't think I'm speaking out of turn when I say that, that sometimes it's easier to behave respectfully than others. Now, that never means that we are to be a doormat. That is to let people walk all over us as though we have no personality of our own. That is not biblical. See, Jesus allowed people to kill him, but he never lost his own personality in it. He never stopped being forceful and loving and caring. His death never stopped that. His torture never stopped that. And so we are to maintain who we are in the midst of those things that might make us get off track from love. And the last thing I want to refer to is Jesus says, as the Father has loved me, that's the way I love you. Is there any greater love in the entire universe than God choosing to love us and to be compassionate toward us and provide for us and give us eternal life at the end? And so, as the Father has loved me, that's the way I love you. May in fact be something we need to learn to say too, although I'm not sure any of us can do that, but we can work towards that. So, in all of these things, we recognize that Jesus loved us. God loved us so much. The God recognized there was nothing we could do to actually do penance for our sins. And so Jesus came and did the ultimate penance for us. He died for us. Jesus said, this is the ultimate love, when someone gives their life for their friends. And Jesus gave his life for his friends. And included everybody, even his enemies. Jesus wanted them to be friends. And so Jesus died for his friends, and he included everyone. Not everyone accepts friendship, but we can pray that we will, and that there will be a light for others to see that kind of friendship that God offers us through Jesus Christ, and that we can live out by the power of the Holy Spirit. May it be so. Amen.
For us and death, for us and
Let us take some time in prayer. We thank you, God, that we can love you because you first loved us. We pray that you would send your Spirit to us in a special way that we might be able to love in the way that you love, that we might care for and about others. Our God, at this time we think of Sally, pray for her family and friends, and thank you that you have taken her into your arms forever. We pray, O God, for all those who are in pain or grief or are suffering. We lift them up to you, O God, and ask that we might indeed not only show our love in our prayers and our actions, but determine and choose to behave in such a way that we would heal suffering by your Spirit and not bring suffering. We thank you, God, for the gift that you have given to us, for you loved the world so much that you gave your only uncreated Son, so that we might believe and not perish, but have everlasting life. We thank you, O God, that Jesus gave us a prayer that we could share together, raising our voices and saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. On the night he was betrayed, the Lord Jesus took bread and spoke a prayer of thanksgiving. He broke the bread and said, This is my body which is given for you. Do this to remember me. When supper was over, he did the same with the cup. He said, This cup is the new promise made with my blood. Every time you drink from it, do it to remember me. The gifts of God for the people of God. You can say the closing prayer with me, please. Jesus, I praise you for your goodness and faithfulness. Even giving yourself as a sacrifice for the sins of humanity to restore the relationship of God and people.
having taken communion, help me to praise you for your atoning work, that even in your suffering, you were prepared for victory. You are mighty, great, holy, powerful, loving, just, truth, and ruler over all creation. Nothing can compare to who you are. I renew my pledge that you are my God. Amen.
That song is sung, I think, by congregations everywhere. That happens to be a Roman Catholic arrangement. I think it's beautiful. I also have a children's version of it, which is very nice, but that seems the one to do today.